All right, hey everybody, it's Lego Jang here with my first look at the first Brain Attack series Hero Factory character that I'll be trying out for the very end of 2012. These are considered to be 2013 releases, but they came out just a little bit early. I was fortunate to find them. So here we are with Furno XL. This is the one single extra large, unusually sized hero out of this series, out of this wave. And he comes with 103 pieces. I'm happy that they got over the 100 piece kind of milestone with this guy. So, like I said, comes in a bag, seems to be following along with what we had seen previously, where they're putting the hero code on the back of the core. So this guy is going to give you 1,000 game points. They've got the new game that's coming out, or by the time you watch this video, who knows, it may already be out. And let me open this up and see what we get. Incredible. So much good stuff here. So much good stuff. All right, let's get into it. First off, with the ball and socket joint pieces, you can just hit the pause button if you want to see exactly what's there and count them out. I've got some miscellaneous stuff that also goes with ball and joint pieces. You can see you've got couple of these that came out, or three of these that came out with the last series, the friction adder add-ons, some of these basic socket joints, torso. I guess I should show you the torso. It's the hero style torso, the extra long one. If you hear anything in the background that sounds kind of weird, like some static in the background, it's because it's raining cats and dogs right now, so apologies for the background noise. It's coming down pretty hard. Armor pieces. First off, in armor, we've got two silver large body armor pieces, the main ones. And then we've got a couple of these wide ones in red, and a couple of number five or five length ones also in red. And then some of these little shorties. These are short, semi-transparent. You call them orange, you call them red, it's up to you. I mean, they look kind of orange to me, but all right, that's those. Got a couple of these little add-on pieces in the gunmetal gray. Feet, two silver feet. I'm happy to see these, the mace halves, large mace halves in gunmetal gray. It's a great color to have them in. You've got these, which are a new piece, and you see these come together to form a Hero Factory logo in the center. Got the little H pattern in there. This is a new blade. I'm pretty sure that this is a new blade. It's got a little bit of flexibility to it, so it's not going to break too easily. It just has a axle connector at one end. And this to me kind of takes you back to the Knights Kingdoms set in its simplicity, as well as its size overall. I believe these are new. At least I haven't seen them before in the sets the themes that I deal with. Some semi-transparent flame pieces that have an axle hole. Now here's another armor piece. This is the new style for this series of main chest armor. So this has a mini pin style little joints around the edge, or peg sized. Got a whole bunch of miscellaneous small little pieces, but we'll just see those as they come up. Nothing too fancy there. This is what I've been saving, because this is awesome. Ah, this is just crazy to have this piece. Ah, so many times in mock building that I could have used this, and it's in gunmetal gray too. I'm gonna wait for these to show up on BrickLink, and I'm gonna buy all of them. I don't have specific uses for them just yet, but I want to use these in so many things. Now, for head, got some interesting things going on here. I'm going extra long here on this first review, because it is the first one, and it's my first time for me showing off some of the new parts that will be repeated throughout this brain attack series. We have a new headpiece. It's got no face on it, so it's kind of a nondescript kind of piece, and it has attachments on two sides, actually, well, four sides really, but it's got the standard attachments from the side for axles, but then to attach something onto face and or head surface, you've got axle hole here, you've got axle hole here, 90 degrees away. And then here's Furno's new helmet with the face on it. It's gone kind of tall with the face this time, a little bit different. I mean, it's still recognizable as Furno, still has the same basic elements, but a little bit different, kind of like a tall nose area, and it's got a little bit more underbite. And then this is a shield or visor that's going to go over the top, and this is actually going to rotate, so that's going to be interesting to see how that works out. And then the very last thing is this piece of amazement. This is a cloth cape, large cloth cape. This is the first, to my knowledge, this is the first large cloth cape that we've gotten officially from Lego since Vezon from the Bionicle series. And I have a ton of the Vezon ones, and I just haven't shown the videos yet of where I've used them, but they're very rare and pretty highly sought after, very expensive on BrickLink. But now we've got new ones, and these are better than the Vezon ones because the Vezon ones have all these tattered cuts in them to make them look old and worn. But this is new and fresh, and just has two little pin or axle sized holes up at the top. And it has a little bit different texture on one side than on the other. On this side, it's almost a felt-like texture. On this side, it's a little bit more like a synthetic fabric, but it's exactly the same material that was used for the Vezon one. And this is great to have. It'll be great to stock up on. And you can use that on heroes and villains when doing mocks. So, like I said, sorry I took extra time for this one to start out going through some of the parts, because it's my first one to open from the Brain Attack series. But now I'm going to move on to the speed build. And there he is, Furno XL from the Brain Attack series, Wave 1. Let's go ahead and take a look at him from a few different angles. Just rotate around slowly, 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 so you can get an idea for what this guy looks like. You can tell that Lego's designers, especially for Hero Factory, play a lot, because they're always coming up with slightly new ways of building things and new ways of pulling off different themes, different types of ideas, different types of connection methods, different ways to build bodies and extend them and add to things and put things together. Definitely, you know, experimenting and giving us some new options and some new inspiration. So with this guy, with the XL in particular, he uses a different body style. So I'll go ahead and raise his arms up and focus on that a little bit first. First off, you know, I'm just going to pull off this back piece temporarily, because this is really going to help to illustrate my point. So you can see that the arms come with this entire separate piece, and the shoulders are mounted way up here and on these little short arms, and they're back from the torso. You can see that the torso attaches here. Then you go back one, two and a half pegs back is how far that the shoulders are offset back. While I've got this off, you'll see they added a little bit of thickness to the center torso towards the rear by adding these armor pieces here. And the upper arm armor is made from these halves of the large mace pieces. And you can see how those are attached right there. It's just plugged right on. So a lot of different stuff going on there. And then switching back to here. So here the normal shoulder joints are used to add breadth to the upper chest of this character. And they use those wide pieces. I think that this whole look right here worked out really, really well. They did a great job there with the shape and how it fills in and how everything kind of goes together. That just works out brilliantly. And to pull that off, they had to move the new style main chest armor piece or chest plate forward, and you can see they use one of those little three hole guys with the one ball joint in the middle to extend forward the center of the torso. And it's different, but it works out. So now I'll just put these back together. You can see it's just two pins, like so. And therein lies a little bit of a problem for me, or one thing that I find to be not quite ideal, is these don't feel all that sturdy. You can see there's a lot of motion because of all the, even when I'm not trying to move the joints, I mean, that's not joint movement in there. It's just kind of loose because of the connections that were used. It's not the most sturdy thing. So it doesn't feel that great as far as, you know, when you're actually moving them around and posing them around for kids that are playing. I do worry that it's going to be a little bit easier than normal to pull some of these things off. Shouldn't be too bad. They did kind of stop things off, but if you get aggressive with it, it's not quite going to be as quick and easy to put things back together all the time if you accidentally pull a joint apart. But interestingly enough, the weight balance I think works out okay, even though they moved the shoulders way back. Still, if you just give them a little bit of arc to the stance, it works out okay. And then the cape. I mean, come on, it's cape. Capes are always awesome. I'm really happy to have another cape. There's different things you can do to slightly change the way that it drapes around the character. You can kind of bring it in a little bit, or you can leave it out. I like leaving it out. Use it a little bit more flat. And naturally, you've got plenty of articulation from, you know, all the normal jointing that is done, even with these large mace pieces that they did for the upper arms. You still have plenty of room because those are kind of offset to the rear a little bit, so that works out. Playability is good in that sense, as far as movement, range of motion and all. They did go with simple legs. Even though they're extra tall, they kept them simple by just using these friction adders rather than using a ton of extra Technic pieces and extra ball joints and such. It keeps them strong enough. You know, it doesn't feel like he wants to bend over accidentally. I can still create some unusual amount of leaning here. Still is kind of heavy, so this is all of his weight balancing on one single ball joint down here. But you can't get every pose out of that. You will reach, there is enough weight that it will reach the limit of the friction in those friction adder joints, as I call them. But I think it stands pretty well. One hand, once again, we've got another hero, a big hero even, an XL hero that only has one hand. And his hand is here holding on to this flame enhanced sword. As of the time that I'm doing this video, I haven't seen any official wording for the names of the weapon and the shield, the flame plasma infused flame shield thing that's over here that can probably also be used as a weapon, but I'm sure that folks will add those into the comments once official names are actually released from LEGO. I don't want to just make up something and call it official when it's not. But here you can see no hand on this side. They just kind of integrated in with one of those socket joints to get new shield pieces in real close and real flat. It looks good though. You know, if you don't specifically think about the fact that he only has one hand on this set, I still think that it looks good, works out well. It doesn't really bother me that just the way that it looks. I think it is pretty good, pretty consistent color scheme, works out pretty well. It's very Furno. There's just a continuous little bit of evolution of his color scheme over time, but it's still staying consistent enough. And the sword here is pretty cool. I kind of like that. They use a little minifig pieces, blade pieces with the little peg. It's a mold that's been used in Ninjago. I'm sure it's been used in some others also. A little bit of detail added in there, a little bit of bulk added with this piece of armor plating that's added on here. I think that works out really well. Adding a little bit, the one little spike behind here, that's good. The new setup for the main chest is interesting to me, the way that these kind of claws come in. Almost looks a little bit insectoid, the way that it just aesthetically comes together. Like their claws or mandibles almost, which is a little bit dark, I think. Not visually dark, but just conceptually dark, you know? Seems like the heroes this time have gotten a little bit more serious and maybe not quite as lighthearted and light in general of heroes, a little bit more business oriented. These are able to rotate also. You can open them up. I don't know how that's actually going to be used. I would expect that to be used somehow as an animation in TV episodes or maybe in the game, but I'm hoping that would actually be used. But you don't want to push these all the way in because they start to, it covers up the hero core altogether and they kind of overlap a little bit, so you want to leave them out a little bit. I wish that they designed this so that these would come together and just stop at the perfect spot, but you have to kind of pose that yourself. And then the head, so taking a look at how that worked out, we'll just angle this up just a little bit. Pretty simple construction. They just put the joint right into the new center head piece, the main head piece, and that allows this visor to swivel up. So that's a cool extra thing. I really don't like his face, especially now that it's on here. Has a little bit of a General Grievous feeling to it, to me. There's a little bit of a little bit of evil, a little bit of comedy. I kind of like his older face, or his younger face, I guess, a little bit better. I understand that, you know, he's gone into XL mode now. He's serious for this wave. He's a big shot. He's not a rookie anymore. So it's good to give him a little bit older, more mature appearance. But I personally, I wish that the nose section was a little bit shorter, or the jaw was up higher. But once you bring this down, once you bring the visor down, much better. So it kind of helps to cover some of that up. That's pretty cool. I kind of like that. You know, it's that little extra thing that you can do. It looks good from the side, especially, I think. Looks better from the side. A little bit of humanoid look to it. Yeah, the Spartan helmet, you know, or face mask kind of thing going on, but it's okay. I'm happy with it. And I think that just about does it for Furno XL for now. As I said, it's my first review from the Brain Attack series. Haven't done Hero Factory reviews in quite a while, because the set, you know, haven't had anything new come out for a while. Other videos that I do after this one, other review videos, will go more quickly. Obviously, all the other ones are smaller sets, but I won't go into great detail of repeating everything that is common between this one and the others. I also haven't done any research. I haven't looked at anybody else's videos. These have come out in other places. I like to approach these with a open mind and just looking at it from my perspective. I don't like to get inspiration from other folks when doing these, because I want to be as original as possible. So if there's any information that has already been figured out, feel free to share it with folks. But for now, that's it from me on Lego Hero Factory Furno XL from Wave 1 of Brain Attack. Thanks very much for watching. If you have not subscribed, please be sure to subscribe. If you haven't added me on Facebook, if you do have a Facebook account, you can find facebook.com/LegoJang. And for all of my updates, including stuff that doesn't come up in videos, it's relatively rare, but you can see hero-factory.blogspot.com. I'll catch you again very soon.